Dear Santa, I'm writing to say thank you for the best Christmas ever. I thought it was going to be awful this year. My parents told me I was on the naughty list for sure. After they saw what I was doing to those animals in the backyard, they even forced me to start seeing a psychiatrist. I was so angry at first, but it turned out to be alright. In fact, he's the one that suggested I start writing you. He told me that if I confessed all my naughty behavior in the letters, that you would probably forgive me and still bring me presents. He even made sure to deliver them to you for me, and it worked! I told you everything from the time I hurt that neighbor girl for fun to this toy dog I tortured. You didn't judge me. You accepted me for who I was. The doctor gave me all the letters you wrote back. My favorite one was the one where you described doing similar things to the reindeer up at the North Pole. I don't remember hearing about a reindeer named Candy, so it must have been a new one. There's also the letter where you said that we were so much alike that I could come be one of your helpers this year. That made me so happy. I waited up for you Christmas night. I have to admit, part of me was scared that you wouldn't show. I'm so glad I was wrong. I should have remembered that Santa wouldn't tell a lie. I did just as you told me. I waited till after midnight when my parents were asleep and watched from my window till you appeared under the streetlight in front of our place. There you were in your big red coat and your thick white beard. You looked just like the Santa at the mall, only you were real. I waited for your signal, and as soon as you waved your white gloved hand up at me, I snuck downstairs and unlocked the front door for you. When you stepped into my home, I was starstruck. I could barely speak, I was so happy to see you. I guess it was a good thing though, because you told me in the letter to be real quiet. Then you reached into your bag and you gave me a present. Shows what my parents know. Naughty kids don't get presents my foot. Then you told me to open it by the tree while you went upstairs to grab the second part of my Christmas wish. I still remember the wonderful smile that spread across my face when I saw the knife I had asked for in the package you gave me. But the best part was hearing the screams from my parents and sisters upstairs bedrooms. I wish I could have seen their faces, but that's what they get for grounding me on my favorite holiday. I could tell by the noises that you spent extra time with my mom and big sister. That was good because mom was the one who pushed dad into spanking me the day they found Mr. Whiskers in the backyard. And my sister is the one who told on me all the time. When you came back downstairs, I could see that your gloves now matched your red coat. And you had a big smile on your face. I still can't believe everyone else thinks you just want some stupid milk and cookies. You didn't even touch the cookies my mom had left out. It was so hard not to laugh the next day when I overheard the cops saying they found chunks of coal stuffed inside your bodies. I guess they have that part of the legend mixed up on Santa. I did like you told me though. I acted very sad and upset when the cops got there. I even got more presents because of it. Apparently, people felt bad for me that they took up a collection at a nearby church and brought me a bunch of toys. Isn't that awesome? Anyway, I just wanted to thank you again. You're the best. I think we should go with your plan next Christmas. I'll knock on doors to get people to open them up. I mean, who would ignore a small 10-year-old boy in his pajamas knocking on their door on Christmas night? Just as soon as they open the door, we can go inside and play with them just like you did with my family. I do have one request though. If I'm going to be your little helper, then I would like to help you when you play with them. I mean, I have to learn sometime, and the neighborhood animals are starting to bore me. We can start with my new foster family. They have lots of rules I don't like. I'm sure the doctor would let you borrow his car again. I'm going to hate waiting a whole year. Maybe my doctor knows the Easter Bunny too. Merry Christmas, Santa. Your little helper, Tommy Madison.
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. Ho, 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 ho.